the Big Ski family and a little marriage tip for you. And this is coming from, again, real time right now. Janice and I get over here to Kona, get some time away. We end up being in the pool last night. We have this deep conversation. It got very frustrating for both of us. Would you say that would be an understatement? In fact, on a scale of 1 to 10, what would you say we were last night?
I would say we were probably at a 4.
4, okay. And 4 is not good, guys. I hate 4s, to be honest with you. Not as bad as I hate 2s, but 4 would probably accurately depict where I was as well. And 4 means, hey.
As far as being able to share, like somebody understand, you know, on the same page.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And again, it's weird because 4 is this moment in time that we're experiencing. We didn't come out here on a 4.
No.
We got in a 4 because of conversations, some things that we were wrestling with. And anyways, that being said, went to bed. And I would say we went to bed. We don't go to bed angry. We went to bed realizing we're tired and we need to talk about this in the morning.
We got up at 4:30 in the morning. And so this probably wasn't the best time to discuss it.
Yeah? Yesterday. Right. Right. So we're just tired, long travels. So we went to bed knowing that was the deal. We woke up this morning and we needed to have a conversation. And through this conversation, again, we came to a deeper understanding of who we are, what the other person's feeling.
And I learned about something I should never do, ever.
So did I.
And I know this.
So did I. I learned something I should never do.
I was trying to communicate a point, and so I ended up saying, it's like, and it said somebody else's marriage.
Or another guy. He compelled us to a couple marriages,
okay, or whatever, and say, and I wasn't comparing him to who he is. It was just like an example of something that person said. And he's like, don't ever compare me. And I didn't mean to do that. But ladies, we can say our point without using a person's name, you know?
For sure.
Ever.
For sure.
You don't ever need to do that.
In that situation, I don't want to be compared to other guys in the way that they lead, the way they manage their marriage, the way they communicate. It's not helpful. And I know it's not helpful if I compare Janice in any way to some other person and say, you're not like Mary, Sarah, you know, whatever, some name of people. It just doesn't ever serve you. No. That's a never. And on my part, I'll be real frank with you, I became aware through this communication that I can make Janice feel like she isn't in the loop or I'm not sharing my true heart or vision with her when I run into people I know and they're having conversations and I insinuate that there's deep, exciting mysteries in the future that we're like anticipating and Janice is going, what is he talking about? And these are like visions I have in my mind, but that I haven't shared with her. Not a good thing to share those or hint at those with others in a public setting without her knowing ahead of time. And some of you guys are going, guys, you're 26 years married and you're just figuring this stuff out. You know, it's funny the way that marriage works. You know,
you can know these things.
And still have to be reminded of them or even learn them in a concrete way for the first time where you create language around it and say, okay, I'm not gonna do that because I sure don't want her to feel undermined. I don't want her to feel out of the loop. I don't want her to feel like we're not one because we are one and we're gonna be one. So, but this is a constant work, guys. Yeah. It's a process and it's not always sunny and in paradise, right? And it's not always just easy. And we opted out of going snorkeling with a group of people today because we needed to stay back and talk and sort through and understand better and get to a place where we can be on the same page. And where are we now? I mean, would you
eight
say?
8 or 9.
You think, again?
Awesome.
Okay, good. Hey, I'm good with 8 or 9.
I feel understood and he feels understood.
And I feel understood and known and we feel like we've had a great time sorting these things out. So guys, that's our little marriage tip for today. 2 don'ts, 2 nevers maybe. Never compare your spouse to someone else, a name or example, and never don't share your vision and then share it with somebody else outside of your marriage and have your wife or your husband hear about it secondhand. Anyways, hope that's helpful for you to do. And again, the heart of it is you're always seeking to be for oneness. You're always striving for unity. And that requires saying no to other people sometimes, other priorities to get time together.
That's right.
Mwah.